We've got a heavyweight debut. There's no one better to talk about the heavyweights than yourself. Yeah. We've got Ricky Gorman in there, who's actually managed now by Paul Smith Jr., someone obviously you know now. Heavyweights, it's a dangerous division. One punch can change it all, as we all know, but what advice could you give a young heavyweight starting out on his journey?
Good question. I mean, I always enjoy watching young heavyweights tip the toe with him, you know. I want him to make a splash tonight. You know, the advice I'd give him, especially in the early fighters, get your name on people's lips. Get the public's attention. Fight in an exciting manner, because you need people to know where you are. And if you're just boxing your way to four round wins, you know, don't get me wrong, he might win on points tonight, but let your hands go. Let your hands go. And trust yourself, you know. But one punch can change everything. So, yeah, the heavyweight division is the glamour division, isn't it? Which is why even a young lad who's pretty unknown making his debut will get people's attention. And, you know, I've heard good things about him, and I'm excited to see him perform tonight. So, good luck to the lad.
Absolutely. And we're going to go into that fight now. More from Big Pricey later on. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, we've got the pro debut of Ricky Gorman. Get yourselves strapped in. It's going to be a good one. I'm going to hand back to the commentary team, Jack Catterall and Dan Murray.
Right, Jack, we've got fight number two coming up. It's Ricky Gorman. And Ricky, he's been boxing since a young age. I've actually spent a little bit of time with Ricky Gorman. So he started boxing, I think, when he was about 6 years old. Had a bit of time off and then kind of got the itch to kind of get back involved, and he's making his debut tonight. Obviously, he's the brother of Nathan Gorman, cousin of Tyson Fury, and he's a very, very confident guy, and I've heard big things about him. He can really, really fight.
Yeah, he's coming from a natural fighting family, though, so...
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, our next battle of the evening.
Heavyweight division.
So introducing first, please welcome into the arena to the red corner, Milan Paolo Cano.
Official weight on the scales, 7 feet, 15 stone.
His professional record, 5 victories, 4 coming by way of knockout. An experienced fighter wearing the black and gold shorts. From Bulgaria, presenting Milan Power Kanon. His opponent this evening, standing across the ring, boxing out of the blue corner. Official weight on the scales, 17 stone, 7 pounds. Tonight, he makes his professional debut wearing the black and orange shorts. Robin Andrich presenting Ricky Gorman. Our referee to give his final instructions.
Here we go, Jack. Fight number two. Got Ricky Gorman making his debut against Milan Pornov.
Yeah, like you said, Danny's coming from a fighting family there.
The microphone.
Coming from a fighting family there, so it's exciting to see how he gets on in his debut.
Yeah, he's very, very confident. Usually with a fight on his debut, you're worried about maybe the nerves setting in, but not with Ricky. Ricky come out straight in the front foot. He's got the weight advantage. Pretty much the start I was thinking was going to happen. I can imagine as a corner man, Jack, you're looking at this, if you're Ricky's training, you're thinking this isn't what we've been working on.
Yeah, straight out of the blocks there, no messing about. Ooh, little switch of stance here into the orthodox position.
Yeah, he's very confident, Ricky. I think he's going to enjoy every moment of this. Mid-20s now, Ricky, so he's not a baby, but plenty of time.
Yeah, he's in the heavyweight division, so he's plenty of time there. And I think nice body shot there going in, but he's probably been around this fighting all his life, so he's going to enjoy this moment tonight. It's his debut right here, and I think he's looking to make a statement tonight.
Yeah, like you say, he was straight out of the blocks, and now he's just settled down a little bit. He's getting to his boxing, he's moving about. I think the early onslaught has had an effect on Milan. I think he realises who he's in there with now, what he's in there with, and he's just kind of backing up a little bit. I think any ambition that he had has possibly been knocked out of him.
Yeah, and I think he's zapped all the confidence out of him in that first 30 seconds now, so it's about Ricky being smart now, picking his punches and being able to get him out of there.
Like you said, Ricky just needs to be smart now and box. It's kind of got the potential this to be a scrappy fight. Milan's in survival mode. He's going to look to be holding when he can. Ricky's just got to keep the distance, stay behind the jab and pick his shots.
Yeah, set everything with that jab now. His opponent is apt of all the confidence. Gone into that survival mode, so Ricky now is going to be smart the way he approaches it. He just want to wing them all in, pick his punches out.
He's working the body well, and I think that's kind of the route to go. See how much he wants to actually be in there, Milan. He's just settling down nice, just moving about, taking his time a bit now. But I think he'll certainly be looking for the stoppage. I suppose he's a big old boy at 17 stone, Ricky. You've got to be careful not to punch yourself out as well.
Yeah, I think it's all a learning experience, first round there of his professional career done. head.
Here we go, round two. Milan's already breathing heavy. I think he's felt that first round. He's taking his time, just weighing his opponent up. Some clever feints, trying to draw a lead. Ricky's just jabbing his way in, feinting his way in. He's looking for something to counter, I think. What a shot. Great shot. Just measured it up nice, just put the jab out and turned it into a hook. Milan come back with his own shot. Ricky's obviously got to be careful. He can't just dive in. But he knows now he can hurt him.
I think we've seen that hook get set up from the jab, like his corner was saying, everything from that jab. He was sending that jab up and down nice then, and it set him up for that great little left hook that he caught him with.
Yeah, it's showing some intelligence out, because from the outside it didn't look like much was happening, but he was just lining him up and, like you say, turned into a hook. I think Milan was as surprised as anyone. Ricky's got to stay switched on here. He's hurting, but a hurt fighter's a dangerous fighter, so he's just got to take his time, get back on that jab. Shots here now, Ricky. Being patient, showing a lot of patience for someone on the debut.
Yeah, and I think he came out of the blocks last now, and second round he's settled it down a bit more, and we've seen quite well that nice left hook and picking his punches a bit better this round.
Just trying with that left hook again, but Milan managed to get his head down. Take a lot of the power out of it. Obviously two rounds to Ricky Gorman. Do you like what you see so far, Jack, with him?
Yeah, he looks good. Yeah, it's always hard to say on the debut, but come out fast in that first round, seen a nice little 10-8 round then in that round, quite a nice left hook. Seems to be listening to his corner in that round then, setting everything up off the jab, and that's where that punch come from, so more of that this next round.
Yeah, like I was saying, spent a bit of time with Ricky. He's very confident, he knows the game, he's been around it like we were saying earlier. And I think you could see that in the last round. He's very composed, he took his time. And I think he looks like a great fighter when he works behind the jab. Picks his shots.
Second round, round three.
Ricky's also managed by Paul Smith. So he's got his career in good hands. Obviously, Paul will guide him correctly, getting the right fights at the right time.
Yeah, he's in good hands with Paul there. He'll be able to manage and make sure the right fights at the right time. Come out back on that jab in this third round now.
Yeah, I mean, we all know the jab's a very important weapon, but he's just keeping him off balance. He's just popping it out.
Ricky's
Just want to see maybe Ricky go through the gears a little bit now. Maybe let that right hand go a little bit. Fingers with his heavyweight, so good body work.
Body shot. The opponent took, Millen took a big gasp of breath there. That body shot definitely landed on another one.
I tell you what, I know this Millen's been down, but he's shown a lot of courage in there, a lot of bravery. Yeah, he's taken some heavy shots.
That third round and was kind of holding the centre of the ring a little bit then. Lovely 1-2 there from Ricky. Millen managing to time up a little bit after that.
Millen's blowing very heavily now.
Two lovely body shots at the beginning of the round, where they took a lot of gas out of Millen.
And again, nice little left hook to the body. It's important with these heavyweights, isn't it, Jack, to stay switched on, because one punch can change anything.
Yeah, definitely. Millen's fighting a little burst, but it's important Ricky stays switched on after his attacks and doesn't get caught in any silly punches. Final round now. Ricky's debut.
Second round.
I think he's enjoyed himself. I think he's looked really classy at times when he's used his jab. I think he's landed some fantastic body shots. And the knockdown was a very good setup as well, setting him up with a jab and just turning it into left hook.
Yeah, I think and Millen, again, a great opponent for a debut. He's caused a few problems and give him a few things to look at.
Yeah, because I suppose Ricky learns a lot more from this than just kind of bowling someone over in the first round. Someone who's going to take his shots and, like you say, pose a few problems of his own.
Yeah, again, as a fighter, we all want that knockout finish, but this early in his career, having his debut, these rounds are going to be so valuable going forward.
Millen just landing his left hook of his own, a nice jab to the body.
Yeah, I think we're in the last round now and we might see Millen have a little go here.
As a fighter, Jack, obviously all fighters are differently. Last round of the fight, you're ahead on points, you're miles ahead. Do you try and go through the gears, or do you just kind of see it to the end and get the victory?
I think you've just got to stay switched on, stay in that moment. Ooh. Just got to stay on, switched on in that moment. Stick to the job in hand, win the round.
Yeah. Millen just growing in confidence, but now Ricky's going to step it up and go through the gears again.
Yeah, Millen swinging some wild punches, which gives Ricky opportunity then to counter them and land some big shots of his own.
Oh, nice.
Nice.
Maybe Ricky, you can see he's always thinking if he's moving back, he's trying to draw him into a shot.
Yeah, some nice head movement there off Ricky.
Yeah, some good feinting.
Wear that jab.
I suppose, like we said in the first fight as well, Jack, is I think Ricky probably needs fighters who are going to throw shots. He's wanting to counter him, but unfortunately Millen from the first bell, I think he felt the kind of pressure from Ricky, and I think he went into his shell a little bit.
Yeah, it's always hard to look good against somebody who's just here to survive, but no, great debut that for Ricky. I'm sure respect there. Nice to see.
Yeah, he's got it out of the way now.
Yeah, so valuable them four rounds now at this stage of the career. Can watch, sit there with his team, watch it back and keep progressing from there.
Thank you. nervous, Aki, I'll be honest, than I've ever experienced in my whole career. I must have been to the toilet about 20 times. I've been sweating up there. It's a different scenario when he's out of your comfort zone, you know what I mean? You're not in charge. But I thought he'd done fantastic. You know, he's fought. You all look at the opponent he fought. The fella recently fought Dave Allen. Ricky's never boxed since he was 17, 18 years of age. So all that inactivity, he has 6 amateur fights.
And he's just going to give me a hug and a kiss, and I've got sweat all over me, sweat everywhere. So you were shouting out, jab, so jab, jab, jab. So obviously you were nervous in the case, both debuts. Okay, but you wanted him to jab a little bit more, didn't you?
Yeah, obviously. It's easier said than done when you're in there. Just jab, open up the tin, get in there, do your work, get back out. But obviously, like you said, it's his debut. He's in with a very tough, experienced opponent, a game opponent. In my opinion, he didn't come up to take his money and go home this time, he called for a fight.
And you know what? He does want to fight, Ricky. He's been trying to, he's had pullouts of fights, etc., etc. This is the stuff people don't see behind the scenes, right? But he wants to fight, doesn't he? He's game.
Oh, he's more than game. If he said to him now, do you want to do another 4-rounder right now? He'd be on it. You know, he just loves to do it. But obviously, he's had a bit of bad luck with what happened, but he's got the right man. He's gone, you know, with Terry, Paul Smith, and everyone else. So onwards and upwards from here, I believe. That was a fantastic debut. I couldn't be any more prouder.
Now, you know what? We've been doing this documentary with him, you know, at home with the Gormans. When are we going to get Nathan Gorman on this documentary at home with the Gormans?
We'll sort that out, 100% happy. We'll sort that out, brother. We'll get on it.
All right, top man. Well, listen, Nathan, look, before we go, very quickly, Nate, what's going on with you next, man?
We're looking at November, mate. I think everyone knows what fight's been mentioned.
Yeah.
You know, hopefully, you know, it's going to be Fabio Wardley for the British title. We're looking at November time. That's where we're at with that one. So it's going to be a fantastic fight. And, you know, one, I think, what the fans can buy into, I think.
Make sure you tune in, Fabio Wardley and Nathan Gorman. That's going to be brilliant.
Right, Terry, tell me, first fight out of the way, woo, debut. You know, you can settle down a bit now, but during the fight, were you happy with Ricky's performance? Talk me through it.
Yeah, he, do you know what I mean? We had a game plan going in, everyone out the window. But, you know, I spoke to our manager, Paul, and he was like, Tess, he was never going to listen to you on your debut. So take that into account. He's not boxed since he was 17 years of age, Rich. So he's had a long time out. He's 25 now. So you've really got to take that into account. But apart from that, he boxed brilliant. Do you know what I mean? We're our own worst enemies. We're like, we could have done that. But that's what always makes us better. But he boxed brilliant. He did box brilliant. He just didn't listen to half the things I wanted him to do.
But you know, he's got that one out of the way now, and it's always, you know, the debut is always the one that nerves.
It's so nerve-wracking, Chris, as you know. It's, you just want it so perfect, and half the time it doesn't go perfect, but he got a great win on a big stage, took it all in his stride, and he needs to celebrate tonight, because that was brilliant. Good debut.
Brilliant. Well, congratulations, mate. You go in, you deserve a good celebration.
Thank you, Chris.
Brilliant.
Thank you.
That's happy, Chris. He's on the road with Ricky now. Give us your thoughts on the performance.
If it was his third or fourth fight, I wouldn't have been happy with it, but it's his debut. So the faults that he had, the problems that he had, where he was loading up a little bit, not using his jab, probably not listening to his corner. It's all classic telltale signs of a pro debut. So nothing to worry about. Got a lot of talent. He's got a long way to go in the game, and he's got to learn on the job. He's got to be busy, he's got to be active, and try and get as many fights as he can in a shorter period of time as he can, so he can establish himself as a good pro and ready and waiting. You know, it's probably his first fight in a long time tonight, and it doesn't matter how much work you do in the gym, actual fighting is under them lights with the small gloves on. You need that experience. So first one out the way, and hopefully try and squeeze those one in before Christmas if you can, and try and just get him as busy as he can. I know what it's like in your pro debut. You're eager, you want to impress, you want to look good, you want to get the knockout, whether you say so or not. The 4 rounds tonight will do him the world of good, rather than flattening some kid in the first round. So I'm happy with that, and nice points win on the way. He knows what to experience now, what to be ready for in his next fight. He's gone the distance, he's done 4 rounds. He also knows what he needs to do with the engine to be able to do 4 rounds at a good pace, then build up to 6, then 8, then 12, and 10 and 12. So you know, he'll be ready and all in good time.
And, you know, under the lights as well, all your family and your friends there. I mean, that takes a bit of doing as well, as you well know. He's got out of the way now, and he's, you know, that's another thing. So just the old occasion sometimes. What do you like to see next for him?
That's all I was saying to him in the dressing room before he went out. So just don't see the red, don't let the red mist creep in. Relax, enjoy it. Make sure you enjoy it and relax. Don't load up. You know, not silly. And first shot when he come out was a big left hook swing, you know what I mean? He didn't listen to anyone, but it's expected of his debut. I'm saying that tongue in cheek with a smile on my face. I'm not upset at all, I'm not bothered, I think he boxed well, and I'm really happy with that performance tonight. What's next for him is I'll have to get on the phone to some promoters and try and get him out there and try and get him a fight. You know, I don't want a deal for him straight away. I don't want a promoter to snap him up so far just yet. I want to get him out there, and I want the promoter to have a look at him first and see what they like, and then making him offer. You know, I want an offer after someone's had him on the show and seen what he's like and how he can perform, because I know he's got a lot under his belt. He's got a lot in the locker ready to showcase. He's just got to put it out there and showcase on fight night, and that might be a little bit of a blessing that, you know, his debut's in, not a televised show, he's out there, he can fight under the lights and get the crowd experience, but not have everyone scrutinising him, judging him on his debut. You know, if I'd have been judged on my debut, I'd never have won a business title or anything like that. I fought as if my life depended on it, and, you know, didn't listen to what I was being told in the corner and everything else, and was panicking about fitness and getting the decision. So your pro debuts are there for a reason, to learn. He's learned now, and the next one, hopefully, if I can get him up before Christmas, we'll have a look. We'll see him again.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Nice to see you. Good fight. Come on, people! Come on!
I fought tonight, you know, honest to God, with all you boys watching, unbelievable. I'm emotional, fuck them. I might as well speak the truth, it's real talk, no context here. I'm emotional. And
I'm 1-0, and I fought someone who's never fought in the debut. That man's just come from fighting a man who's had a 10-0 victory, a man who's had 28 professional fights who's fought for two Commonwealth Championships, to a man who's not had a fight and said after 7 years of not being in the ring and saying, I'll fight him. With a man who's had, out of his 5 wins, 4 knockouts, and said, I'll have a go with you. On my debut, certain people, not mentioned certain names, certain superstars, said to me at ringside, why have you had him for a debut? They couldn't believe it. They was like, whoa. And the gentleman that I fought said, it's the fittest he's ever been. And certain people who's fought in the past, he never trained for and just came in there. He said, but I trained for you. I trained for you, he said. I was fit. I was ready in the gym, he said, ready to put on a display. And I respect that man, because he took some big wallops. And that ain't the best of Ricky Gorman, you know, that's me. And I ain't speaking, I ain't big-headed, you know, people. I'm me. I'll sit with Tom, Dick and Harry and have a pint of beer, and I'll always be me, you know that. That's me on, I'd say, truthful. And to God, boxers can speak and say what they want. That's me on 30%. I got tonsillitis.
Yeah,
I ain't really well.
A bit under the weather, really, but you didn't want to say that.
No, right? No, I never said it at all.
You know, no one mentioned it, and you've had a sore throat.
Because I didn't want people saying to me, after the fight, coming up to me saying, oh, Ricky, how you feeling? I said, I'm 100%. That's what I wanted to say. I'm 100%, mate. I got a baby in hospital as we speak right now. You know what I'm saying.
No one knows that as well. That's the other thing.
No one knows that.
You had the weigh-in yesterday. We go and sit down for something to eat, and you get a call straight away, and your old demeanour changed, and rightly so. You
was with me.
All your daughters.
You was with me. You was with me. You was with me.
And that's, anyone who knows got children understands that's very. You're going into a fight there to get your head around that.
I done it for my baby. I done it for you, Milani, and I got him. We got him, babe. We got him. Give you a big kiss, my bird, when you come home. And love you, and kiss you, and your old dad's here. You know, I'm here. And I thank you. You watch me, and whoever watches me, I swear to you, I ain't got an ego. I'm humble, and keep following me boys' channel, British Boxing TV, and not out of advertising. I'm saying it because you want true boxing, you want true boxing people, will follow the people. If you don't want to watch true boxing people, forget it. Just forget it. The people just put proper stuff on what's real. We ain't edited, I ain't scripted. Look at me, for God's sake. Yeah, look here. God bless. Irish Shamrock on there.
I'm on a. Look at it. I've got to sing something tonight as well.
We've had some brilliant tunes.
Do you know what it is, Ricky? You could see, like, the amount of times you have to make your debut and it's been called off and you've had all these setbacks. You can see the relief in you now, you know, just to get it over with. Get on then and get on that track and get on the run on the ladder.
I'm
and
here.
Off you go. And it's like there's a lot of pressure off you now and you can really knuckle down and
really
get on with
is. It. It really it is. You know something, it is. It is a. It's a big relief. Because I'll tell you why. Excuse me. It's a unbelievable relief because I fought tonight in Bolton Stadium on my debut. But unbelievable, you boys being all here. All me fans of it. Terry, people, BBTV. In front of all me people, I didn't dare tell him that I had tonsillitis. Under no circumstances. No, I ain't joking. It's there. I ain't a joker. I'm a man's man.
Yeah, I knew you wasn't quite right. You said,
I just be real, say it how it is, and I respect that little guy, you know. Oh, not so little, shall I say. Little, but not so little. I respect him. He came in game. He came in tough, durable. He had no respect for me, he said.
He said he wanted to beat you, didn't he? He said he felt disrespected.
He felt disrespected that I took him on for a debut. He went, why disrespect me? You know, I understand that. I mean, out of 1,300 heavyweights in 1,400 heavyweights in the world, he's ranked number 527. Let's get that right.
I beat the number 527 in the world on my debut. But nothing means nothing without the love and support of these people. I'm a showman, and if there's no one to show for, I don't like boxing. I like my fans, I love you, I love all these people. If there's no show, I can't be a showman. And I love me people, I love me fans, I love me true family. And I love me pals. I am honest, I am straight. And for everyone out there following me and supporting me journey, thank you. And I mean it, thank you, you know, just for a real man's talk, thank you. And keep supporting. Because now I'm on the ladder, I'm going to keep going. So for those of the people that I want to apologise for, some of my personal friends who couldn't be here tonight because they had to go to the Conor Benn fight because they already brought tickets previous because I didn't know I had an opponent till Wednesday. As you know, I didn't know I had an opponent till Wednesday. And hey, I ain't a man to shy away from a fight. I'm a fighting man. It's what I do. I'll have a fight. You want to fight me? I'll fight you. No problem at all. Rain, blow or snow, sunshine. You tell me your boxing gloves is on and you seen that personality at me tonight. You tell me your boxing gloves is on you. I'll have a go with you in 2 seconds. No problem, because I'm a man's man, I'm a fighting man. And thank you. And big up my boys, British Boxing TV.
God bless you, Ricky. God bless you.
God bless you. And big up all me family here, all on this table. Me coach, Terry Spencer, a man who's gone through burdens with me. Yeah, you know something, I'll be really honest on this camera right now. That man, honest to God, right to God, has gone through burdens with me. Burdens. Are you alright, Rick? How's your mind? I'm sorry to hear about your daughter. He's my coach, and I think the world of him. And we're friends. He's like, you know, he's one of me best friends. And we'll speak to one another, and we'll tell each other things, and he'll say, Ricky, you alright? I couldn't tell him tonight I had tonsillitis. You know what I mean? My tonsils like two marbles in my head. I couldn't tell him that, and I wasn't going to. I'm the old man, I'm going to be honest. I'm going to say how it is. I'm not going to tell anyone. You've watched me box, I've said it after a fall. After. Not as a milk, right? I've got tonsillitis. Oh, let's put the pity on Ricky. No. I fought tonight. I had a box. I've done my debut. And I've got tonsillitis. But whoop-dee, effing do. But that lad has gone through so much shit with me.
I had a chat with him earlier. Yeah, he's very happy. He's very happy. But Ricky, you'll have a little rest, get back in the gym, and the journey continues. And we'll be there. We'll be following it. And I'm very proud of you tonight. What you've been through.
You're like a brother to me. You know that, don't you? I mean that.
Absolutely.
You know that, don't you?
You know that.
I do. Yeah. On the road with Ricky.
On the road with Ricky. We will be back on the road again soon.
We're going back on the road again. Oh, right.
That's
the
space. Where are we going?
Hey, people. So, switching from the fight side onto the other side, on the road, we're going to fetch you along. Lovely to have you on one of these. Yeah. Mouth organ, man. Whoa, unbelievable.
Yeah, he's not been in since 1 and 2, has he?
I got people a little idea coming up for next week. Hey, first of all, never mind, just for 1 second. Big round of applause for British Boxing TV for hosting a brilliant show tonight. Unbelievable, packed out the house, brilliant.
Looked good, didn't it? Yeah,
fantastic. And all going back to
names
the
at ringside, like we said, we had David Price there.
David Price said, beautiful. He said, you've learned loads in there. And let's get back to another story here. At home with the Gormans, all you fans, which tip me hat. No, I ain't got a hat, but tip my head. Thank you. Thank you for watching me, Chris Gorman, Aki, Chris Malin. Everywhere we go, what we do, it's unscripted. It isn't written. It's off the cuff. We don't even know ourselves what we're going to do. And you guys love it. And I thank you for loving it. Because it's good, honest, realistic stuff. And me, I ain't going to change.
When are you back in the ring?
Back in the ring?
November, we're talking yet? Maybe, you said, maybe. We want to see
if
you.
If I can get a course of antibiotics down me on Monday morning, get down to the hospital. Doctor, sorry. Get a course of antibiotics into me. Get rid of this shit. Excuse me, sorry. Get rid of this, what I've got. Get rid of it quickless. And once I've got rid of it, I would like to fight in the next 2 weeks. Fortnite, I'm rolling. I'm enjoying it now. So, next fortnight, and most people won't believe this, but a better opponent. I ain't here to make up the numbers to fight a tomato can. What's the sense? I ain't here to fight, oh, look at him, he's fighting a punch bag in the corner. What gains am I going to get out of that? The man's going to look and say, well, he's fought a punch bag and beat him up. I don't want people to say, oh, well done for fighting a punch bag. That's right, isn't it? Exactly.
Top fucking draw, Ricky.
Thank you. This is Terry's uncle.
Ricky's the man.
Oh, thank you. The boys from Newcastle here, look.
The boys, yeah.
From Derham.
Had a good night.
Sorry, Ricky.
You fear no one, mate. You fear no one. You fight every man. You fight every man who is ready to fight you. You ain't gonna fight no one who's not ready to fight you. You will fight every man who's ready to fight you. And you will conquer, and you will go on, and you will win. You're the champion in the making, mate. Champion in the making.
Tonight's the first night I've watched Ricky tonight, and I'm a big fan of him already because of how he performed in that fight. He didn't give up, and he was the underdog in that fight. Very proud of him, son.
Thank you very much. God bless, thank you. Hey, look at that, you know, lad I just met, a gentleman, you know what I mean? Really respectable man. Terry's uncle there, basically like a family member to myself, saying all lovely words. Thank you, you know, it's nice. You know, I ain't an ego person, I ain't got a chip on my shoulder. I'm a realistic man, I'll have a pint with anybody. That's who I am, and if you like that, well, that's it. But if you want to follow a fake person, what ain't even real, go and follow them. You want to follow just generally someone of the public who is still one of the public. No matter where I go, where I don't go, I'll always be one of the public.
Everyone knows you, Ricky. I don't want
championship status or keep me on a pedestal. If these boys are here, hey, Rick, got a pint? Yeah, please. It's been a training camp, obviously I can, but if I can, I'll have a pint.
Everyone's going to see some of the celebrations on here with the guitar and Chris Crom and they're having a sing song. But yes. Ricky, enjoy your night, you deserve it.
Thank you.
Can't wait to see you back in there again.
Thank you very much.
Never give in, even when you think you can't take anymore. Never give up, never give in.